Today, I have the pleasure of interviewing Dan Blondal of Nano One Materials. How are you today, Dan?
I'm great, thank you. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you.
Well, I'd love to just start by congratulating you. Last time we spoke, you had the Saint-Gobain deal, and now you have the Pulead Technologies deal.
Yeah, that's right. So we put a joint development in great agreement in place with Pulead in mid-January. They're a very prominent cathode producer in China, supplying the LFP market, that's lithium iron phosphate, and supplying the lithium cobalt oxide market as well. So that's the materials that go into your iPhones. Very exciting company to be working with.
For all of the clean tech and sustainability directed investors out there, I think you should also, this is major inroads for you, for Nano One Materials into China, into the Chinese market, is that correct?
That's correct. So Pulead are the world's largest producer of lithium iron phosphate, and that's the material that goes into electric buses, goes into lower range electric vehicles. So it's very much kind of the urban solution to decarbonizing cities, and that's a very, very, very big part of what they do. And they supply companies like BAIC, we're one of the largest auto cos in China, and they're starting to supply people outside of China as well. Very reputable player.
And for all of you cannabis investors out there that think the only place you can make money, you are one of the best moving stocks in the market last year. Can you tell us why you were able to compete when many companies had a hard time even maintaining their stock prices last year?
I think partly we play in the clean tech space. We play a little bit, of course, in the battery materials space because we're close to lithium and nickel and cobalt and iron and phosphate and all the key things that make a battery go. And there's a lot of push on the electric vehicle side, whether it be on the industrial buses and grid storage, renewables. This would be storing energy from wind or solar technology, or be it from all the excitement in the electric vehicle space, long range electric vehicles. All of that's very, very frothy. There's lots of excitement in that marketplace, and so we kind of play in both those fields, both in the technology and the battery material side. So that makes us accessible to a wider range of the marketplace.
Of course, I'm known for asking the tough questions. I have to ask you, is it too late to get in?
Absolutely not. We're obviously we're a public company, traded on the venture exchange, NNO.V, and always available to get in. We've got lots of exciting news, I think, in the coming year. We continue to work with other parties, undisclosed, in the space, at the Tier 1 automotive level, internationally, both in kind of Europe and in Asia. So you can expect to see us making further deals and further agreements with people as time goes on. So yeah, there's lots more to the story to come.
Okay, so what should we anticipate in the next quarter? Can you tell us anything?
Well, we'll continue to work forward with Pulead. That's really towards building. We would like to be building a plant with them in the coming years, and so we're working on the design of that plant and how that might look in form, so that you can expect to see news coming out about that. We've always got news about patents because we've got lots in the pipe right now, so you can expect to see continued news about that. And then lastly, our involvement with the automotive side of the electric vehicle space is really a sort of big part of what we're working on right now, so you can expect to see news about that as well.
Well, Dan, as always, it's a real pleasure. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure being here with your audience. Thank you.